My name is Ian Pearson. I'm an applications engineer with Microchip. I also look after the wireless and IoT group in Europe, where we concentrate on wireless and IoT products. And today we're going to look at this device, which is a PIC IoT WG board, and it's to allow us to connect to the Google Cloud over Wi-Fi. So what's on the board? It's a Wi-Fi based board. Therefore, we have a Wi-Fi module for connecting to the infrastructure. We have a microcontroller, which is the heart of the board. We also have on the board a crypto authentication device, or what we would call a secure element for storing the security keys. There are some sensors and also a debug solution. And we also fitted a lithium polymer battery connector. With that comes a Microchip lithium polymer charger. And to help in that system, there's also a DC to DC converter. Ultimately, this is about how do I quickly and easily connect myself to a provider, such as in this case, Google IoT. Out of the box, it does some very simple stuff, which is to connect to Google. With the board comes an account that Microchip run and pay for with Google, and that allows you to authenticate the board when you connect it. It connects there, it opens up your board ID, and it shows you then a couple of graphs on the board, which is both the temperature sensor and the light sensor. Locked away on the secure element are the public and private keys generated securely inside the device. During secure element programming, the public key is read out and provided through a secure backend directly into the device registry of the Google IoT account. On connection, an MQTT session is established. Then, using the keys held in the secure element and leveraging JWT, or the JSON Web Token method, it authenticates the device against the credentials in the device registry, JWT acting essentially as a short-lived secure password. That basically means that when it does that first connection, what it does is to authenticate that this device is who it says it is. And it does that through that security information. Then it knows, yes, the data comes from me, goes into my particular account, and that data is from this board. If you are trying to connect to the internet, then it can be a daunting task. Many of the solutions try to push you towards doing middleware, doing RTOSes, doing complex development, and not all developers want to go that route. So this is trying to help that middle ground where I need to connect, it needs to be secure, and I'm comfortable programming on this level of device, I'm comfortable making my application. So we bury the complexity in libraries within the Microchip MCC code configuration toolset, allowing developers the freedom to innovate. This board is about simplicity. How do I connect to the internet? How do I do that securely? And how do I do that using a microcontroller I'm comfortable developing with to get me there quickly and easily? For more information, visit the links below.